Dear children, welcome back. After a long time we are meeting. It's a great pleasure to me that though I am meeting you through this video once again, but the situation which is around us going on nowadays, it's not good. And this time only the prayer can work. So we all should pray to God to heal the world very soon. So with this, today we are going to discuss that about great circle and small circle, which in the previous year or in the previous session, it was not there in our syllabus. But this time, I think some of you were asking about great circle and small circle, so we can discuss. Now children, we will learn that what are great circle and small circle. Here I already have written some note for saving the time. Here all meridians of longitude and the equator, which are known as the great circle. Except equator, other latitudes are known as small circle. So why these are known as small, why all the meridian and equator known as the great circle? Here first you have to understand, all the great circle will pass through the middle part or the center of this earth. Okay, and will divide the earth into two equal halves. This is the main important point. Here if I am drawing the earth, this is the sphere, and here this is the equator. As we know, this is dividing the earth into two equal halves. It's also dividing the earth into two equal halves and passing through the middle part of this earth. Okay, so this is the great circle, and it's having the maximum circumference. Whenever we will go towards northern pole side and southern pole side, gradually the circumference, it will gradually decrease, and it is not dividing the earth into two equal halves. You are getting to see that the circumference also reducing, as well as that it's not going the middle part of this earth. This is the middle part. Okay, so these are not the great circle. Only equator, which is the 0 degree equator, is the great circle. Fine, understood? Now on the other hand, why all meridians are the great circle? Here this is again I am drawing. Here you know that the meridians are passing like this way and joining north pole and south pole. This is the one side, but if you will see the back side of this arc is also completing us full circle. It's completing full circle and it's passing the middle part of or the center of this earth. Okay, the back side also you can see is completing a circle this way. This way completing a circle. And on the other hand, if I am also drawing another meridian, so it's also passing through this. This way all the meridians which are passing basically to the middle part of or the center of this earth, all are great circle, because the one side we are getting to see these are arc, one side we are getting to see these are arc, but the back side they are completing a full circle. Okay, if you will see the 3D earth on the globe or a 3D feature, if you are having, you can see it's passing through this north pole. And one more important point, the great circle route is the shortest distance between any two places on this earth, between any two places. Now between any two places, so which route will follow? The great circle route and the arc we will follow. The radius of the earth we know the maximum, basically the circumference wherever 360 degree we know, and the part of this radius, and whenever we are talking about arc, so this is the shortest distance between any two place. Suppose here a place A and this is the place B. So this is the shortest distance. It can be the direct distance of the arc. This distance can be the shortest one. Okay. Now children, see here two points given, C and R. So the shortest distance between these two places, C and R, will be the great circle route, which is the arc and the shortest distance. But on the other hand, round line is the longest distance. Here another also picture showing the distances between New York and Paris. Here the distance showing by red color, it's the shortest distance, shortest arc, and the great circle route. Okay, and some more information given here, you can read that. See student, here is a very nice diagram given. here over the North Pole, when we are also seeing that from one meridian to another meridian is crossing over the pole, and between two that also places the shortest distance, how we will measure? Here this is the arc, the shortest arc, okay, shortest distance, we can say direct distance between two places, red mark. But if we want to reach through other route, then you can see these are the longest route will be here, okay, here. But whenever we are going through this shortest arc or shortest distance and following the great circle route, it will save our time, it will save the fuel as well as save that that it will be economical, we can say that. See children, whenever we are measuring the shortest distance between two places which is crossing the polar area, here this is good for the flight or the airways, not for the sailors, because this Arctic area, Arctic Ocean and that Antarctic in the southern pole, these are having icebox, having a foggy weather which can cause that dangerous that accidents. That's why these places, polar area, restricted for the sailors, but we can use that flight or that air route, okay. So I think you have understood what are the great circle and what are the small circle and the characteristic. I think all of you have seen.